National Research Council of Canada described the Philippine deuterium wealth in this manner. A big deposit of 868 miles long, 52 miles at widest point, and 3 miles at the deepest point, replenished by nature 24 hours a day after deuterium travels more than 12,000 kilometers from Central America to the Philippines through the span of the Pacific Ocean when planet Earth turns on its axis from west to east in unending perpetual motion. Dr. Hollog said its economic potential in this breeds is about 12 million barrels per day capacity priced at $7 per barrel. This is $84 million per day or $30.66 billion per year, enough to wipe out all existing foreign debts of the Philippine government in 1 year, revenue-wise in foreign exchange. Dr. Hollog said that once deuterium exploration and extraction succeed, public works, private construction, economic and financial booms are expected to happen in the Philippines in the same manner as those which happened in the Middle East and financial centers of the world from 1974 to 1984, with everybody earning their respective comfortable livelihood while pricing basic prime necessities at reasonable and affordable levels. Oil rig platform manufacturers in Singapore can fabricate specially designed platforms for used 100-150M or approximately P57.5 billion. For a total cost of P10 billion for research and construction of a single floating deuterium rig with an average production capacity of 50,000 barrels a day, the government can expect a conservative daily income of $4 million or $1.2 billion per year, which is equivalent to P54.0 billion annually. If the government constructs one deuterium rig every year generating an annual income of $1.2 billion, our World Bank loan can be totally wiped out in less than 15 years. The budget for this venture is well within the means of our government. If the government can afford the president's P40 billion pork barrel in 2006 for assorted poverty alleviation programs, our government can afford one deuterium rig every year, which has a 100-fold cost-benefit ratio. Estimates show that there are only 1,000 billion barrels of reserve petroleum left in the world today. With the world's annual consumption of 28.6 billion barrels, all reserve oil will be fully used up 35 years from now. World energy requirements will have to be shifted then to natural gas, which still has 5,457 trillion cubic feet in reserve. But this particular source is still subject to depletion. Hydrogen, which has an abundant and unlimited source in deuterium, will be the future energy reserve. If the Philippines can tap this energy source, we can have a much better future and economic position than the rest of the world, including the United States of America. Should we as a nation will have reached this point in our history, the Philippines can then be described as the fabled promised land, a land flowing with milk and honey. The United States of America once dreamed of sending a man to the moon. Now it is history. What she did to pursue the dream made her the world's most technologically advanced and economically prosperous nation. This could happen to the Philippines. Here's the latest update. Courtesy of Refles Kluman. Filipino-Norwegian conglomerate to explore mine deuterium gas deposits in Surigao. At Thursday, November 25, 2010, a Filipino-Norwegian conglomerate who formed an exploration and mining firm, Surigao Island Mining Development Corporation, have already expressed to explore and mine huge deuterium gas deposit in Surigao Island that will be based in the coastal town of Pilar. The conglomerate applied 1,500 kilometers wide, long and deep area concession from Pilar, Surigao del Norte and Surigao Island. Thus, exploration will even reach mainland Surigao. Machigas, who is chairman on the House Committee on Environment, told newsmen present at the press conference. In a press conference held at the provincial capital here, Friday, 1st District Surigao del Norte Rep. Francisco Machigas and Surigao del Norte Governor Saul Machigas announced that the conglomerate already applied for a land survey exploration permit with the Bureau of Mines and Geosciences. At the land survey preparations and exploration alone, we expect hundreds of Surigaonans to be employed by the conglomerate, the Surigao del Norte Solon said. Machigas said that last week conglomerate officials meet with him and the governor to discuss their application with the Philippine government's Bureau of Mines. Deuterium gas is also known as heavy hydrogen, is a heavier and stable isotope of ordinary hydrogen, and is now widely known worldwide as fuel of the future. It is a colorless, odorless, non-toxic, diatomic, flammable gas. Deuterium gas is used in nuclear power, fusion power, deuterated optical fibers, deuterated lubricants, lasers, light bulbs, R&D laboratories, and annealing semiconductor rim. The Philippines was identified to hold the greatest amount of deuterium deposit in the world somewhere in the area known as Mindanao Trench, the part of the Pacific Ocean just off the shores of Surigao Island. Deuterium Nu is the white gold in the Philippines is most prevalent in an area more widely known in the whole world as the Philippine Deep, which is located here in Surigao, Philippines, the Deuterium Project. 20 years ago, a certain Dr. Nona Colo from Butuan City in Mindanao hypothesized that a very large deposit of deuterium can be found in the Philippine Deep, located off the waters of Surigao. First discovered and isolated in 1932 by an American chemist Harold Urey, deuterium or heavy water is composed of two isotopes of hydrogen and an oxygen atom, with the chemical formula of D20 or H.